What's going on, everybody? It's your community manager over at Player First Games, NAKAT, and today I am here to teach you Agent Smith from the Matrix. Agent Smith is one of the newest additions to the MultiVersus roster, and so I hope that this guide is able to not only help you learn how to play him, but of course, maybe actually garner more interest from you in this character. Now, without further ado, let's get into the passive. Agent Smith has a passive ability called Gun Fu, where Smith uses his gun for close range melee attacks that also destroy projectiles. He fires his gun 1 to 3 times whenever he shoots, and this is controlled by his meter, with more shots coming from more meter. Shooting consumes his meter, while melee attacks without his gun refresh it. So, there is an ammo system on this character, and you're going to actually need to hit your opponents to gain some of your ammo back. This is very, very important. Keep that in mind, because the more bullets, the more damage, and of course, the more power. So, remember that. Now, for Agent Smith's weaknesses, doesn't have too many, but his speed isn't among some of the fastest in the game, but he's also not that slow, but he also has a reliance on ammo, as you can see. Under my name, you see the bullet right there, and you see the 3. That's gonna be very important. So keep in mind, he is ammo reliant. His strengths, let's talk about Agent Smith's strengths. So he has solid KO power. His range is something else. He has a gun, but also he has his fists as well that reach far. And he is very good at edge guarding off of the stage. As you can see, when the opponent is trying to come back, you have a multitude of options to actually pressure, even with this spike, which is very, very strong. But with fighting Jason, obviously he ain't die that quick. But just keep in mind, this move is going to be very crucial off stage, not to mention with your ability to also aim down and shoot people as well, or even fling yourself at them too. Or if you want to even get a little spicy, you can do that move too. And we're going to go over all of these moves in this guide. But of course, let's get into the moves themselves in general. Agent Smith's dash attack. His dash attack is him sliding on the ground and shooting as many bullets in the chamber as he possibly has. There you saw that I had 3, so I was able to do 12 damage off the rip because I was able to shoot 3 bullets in a row. Now, if I do a dash attack with 1 bullet, yeah, I get 1 shot, but it's not going to have the same damage as, you know, shooting 3 shots. This is why, again, his moves that require the gun, you want to be very, very, very attentive to, because that's going to be the difference between damage or, of course, knockback as well. Keep in mind, with 2 bullets here, as you can see, I'm able to let off 2 shots and that pops Jason away. But ultimately, you want to hit 3 if possible. At higher damage ratios, this move actually has the ability to potentially kill. So keep that in mind as well. If your opponent is just sitting at the ledge right here, if you're able to let off a dash attack, you will have the ability to ring them out. But as you saw, with 1 bullet, it's not going to have the same KO potential until much later versus if you had 3 or 2 bullets in the chamber. Agent Smith's side attack is a flurry of punches that lead into a grab that allows him to punch the opponent away as a final blow. Keep in mind, in the second part of this move, when you're doing these rapid punches, you can actually cancel into your other moves, such as your down attack, or you can cancel into your up attack as well. So if you don't want to just finish by doing the grab confirm and just knocking the opponent away, you have these 2 options, which allow you to follow up into other moves as well. And if you really want to get spicy, you can actually do jab 1 into gun. So there's a lot of variety with this character, right? And if you even want to get spicier, you can actually do jab 1-2 into gun as well. So just keep that in mind. He has a lot of different routes outside of his jab combo, other than just finishing the entire jab combo and just being done with it. Side attack has a lot of versatility, and that's something that makes him not only really good to play, but it just feels good to be able to have that much more control over what routes you go into with the character. Something also to note with his rapid jabs is that you're actually able to turn around the throw as well. So if you don't want to throw forward, you could turn it around and throw them the opposite way at the end of the move. All it takes is you just turning the character once he grabs them with the control stick. Agent Smith's neutral attack is a command grab. When grabbing the opponent, if you have this move up and you haven't used it already, he will apply this mechanical insect-like creature to the opponent that actually silences them. What silence does is it doesn't allow their cooldown moves or any moves that they have that are on cooldown to refresh while the silence is active, which can prevent certain characters from using certain moves as well. So, for instance, if Jason applies his armor, and I grab him, he will not be able to replenish any of that ability to get his armor back until that silence is done because of the command grab. Now, as you can see, I don't always have that little mechanical insect all the time, so if I don't have it, I just grab and do a quick headbutt. Keep something in mind though. At higher percents, this command grab is very, very strong and has the ability to kill. So actually being able to catch your opponent off guard and ring them out with that move is very strong, even if you're not trying to apply the silence debuff. In this game, having a command grab is pretty good, and so neutral attack being just that will allow you to call out opponents that often are either standing still, in place, or of course, if you're able to read them rolling behind you, you can just turn around and grab them. Agent Smith's down attack is a punch down to the ground that launches the opponent a little bit further away from him. Doesn't really have too many true follow-ups because of how much lag it has at the end of it, but it is definitely a good move of just distancing the opponent away from you and just knocking them away. Now, keep in mind, again, you can combo out of it when you do your jab 2, or of course, even if you just do your jab 1. And if you want to try to gap close against your opponent, you can actually just do a dodge jump toward them. That way you are able to kind of close the distance when you punch them away. This move's utility offstage is pretty decent, being able to pop opponents away, sometimes even diagonally in trajectory. So even if you are at the ledge, you will still be able to find use of this move. Agent Smith's up attack is a punch upward from the ground. As you can see, the upward variant in the air also resembles the same thing as it is on the ground, allowing you to actually branch into other moves very quick, even into the move itself once you enter the air. This move will immediately take you into the air as well. As you can see, his feet are leaving the ground. So you enter your aerial state as soon as you use this move, versus some characters that don't leave the ground at all and you just have pretty much open range to all of their grounded options. Agent Smith is a little different because this is popping him up. This move is very good for trying to counter characters that want to land on top of you, air dodge down toward you, and all of the above, really. So that was a perfectly timed air dodge, but if you wait it out, you can actually punish the opponent when they air dodge down from a situation in the air. So keep in mind, very good anti-air tool, and has the ability to kill and link into itself. Aerial side air is one quick swipe forward, knocking away the opponent. This is a very good move to chase with due to its range, and of course, as you can see how fast it is, has the ability to pretty much knock opponents out of situations where they want to throw a move out, or let's say they expend a resource and want to use a jump. This move is going to be one of your key moves off stage to edgeguard with, especially with all the other moves in his arsenal, such as downward aerial and his up special and even his gun. But there's even more moves for you guys to check out that you can use off stage, and we will get to that at some point. However, with the aerial side attack, just keep in mind that you do want to approach with this move, and you can even fade back with it as well. If you feel like your approach isn't going to pay off, you can kind of cut your momentum. That way you have a hitbox in front of you to protect you while also threatening the position of your opponent. Aerial neutral air is about the same as the neutral air on the ground. It is the command grab in which you are able to throw the opponent. And of course, if I don't have my little insect, I will just do a quick headbutt and hit the opponent. Down air is a thrust downward with both of his feet. It is a super duper strong kick, and this is again one of your most key moves for edge guarding, as not only is the move large, but it also applies an enormous amount of pressure because your opponent wants to try to avoid this at all costs. So they're going to burn dodges, they're going to burn resources trying to avoid that move. And what you want to do is you want to put them in a situation where they feel like they have to press, and then you're able to catch them at the end. And if your opponent is holding onto the wall, that is also a very, very good opportunity for you to set up to try to spike them as they try to come back. Hitting your opponent on the ground with this move will also allow you to combo into some of your other aerials as well, as this move has enough hit stun for you to be able to chain into other options too. So get really creative on how you try to combo your opponent out of down air. You can whip out the gun. If you make a hard enough read, you can actually try to use your up special, which takes a bit more skill because it won't be guaranteed. You can do a forward air. There's a lot of different variations to come from this move. So this is a move that you will want to use in neutral stance as well on stage. You don't want to just use this for edge guarding. You can approach with this option. Granted, it will leave you exposed horizontally, but that's up for you to overcome. Time and place in terms of when you want to use it, but don't just not use it on stage because you might think it's only good for killing off stage, because that's just not the case. It's a very, very good move to approach with as well. As mentioned before, Agent Smith's upward aerial is about the same as his grounded up attack. Basically, he is doing a thrust upward with a punch, but in the air. So as you can see, I'm able to chain this together pretty easily, right? Now, if I want to approach an opponent straight up, the move is big enough for me to catch them on the ground with me just starting out with a jump. Now, the big thing about this move is that the fact that it has this ability to juggle as much as it does. So you're able to keep the opponent above you, which is very, very crucial in a game such as MultiVersus as a platform fighter. Being above the opponent is not always a good thing. In most cases, it's actually just not a good thing at all. So you have to be very, very careful when you willingly put yourself above someone. The thing with Smith is because he's able to actually get people above him so well because this move is so good, it allows him to not only get a bunch of confirms, but also, of course, kill the opponent in situations where he reads a dodge or a defensive option while they're in the air to close out the life. Let's talk about Agent Smith's specials. Agent Smith's side special on the ground. Let's check this out. This is 3 bullets. This is 2 bullets. And lastly, this is 1 bullet. See the difference in damage? The more bullets, the better. And so effectively with side special, this is not only a long reaching move as he dives toward the opponent, but you want to get the most bang for your buck in terms of how early you're able to kill with this move. This move is great not only as a pressure tool because of how far it goes, but of course, even off stage, if you want to edge guard with it, it is an option that you definitely will want to have in your arsenal. The more bullets, the more range. So in this case, if I really wanted to do as much damage as possible, I want to have my chamber as filled to the brim as I possibly can. So at 114 on Jason, as you can see, I have 3 bullets. He's at 131 at the ledge. It's like, all right, whatever, cool. Even if I want to just simply approach with this move, do you see not only how far it goes, but just how strong of a move it is? Just keep that in mind. This is going to be one of your go-to options that will definitely throw opponents off, whether you're trying to edge guard with it off stage or you're trying to hit them while they're on the stage. This is why bullet management matters a lot, because as you can see, not only do you have to manage bullets in terms of just side special, your dash attack, your neutral special, it's just a lot to think about. And there's one more move in his specials arsenal that actually requires him to use ammo as well, which we will get to momentarily. But this is Jason at around 72. Jason can stand right here, and I will show you the knockback again of this move, right? So at 72, he didn't hit fully over to the blast zone, but he was approaching there. So keep in mind, this is a move that you're really going to want to use as much as possible. Neutral special is interesting because neutral special, in my opinion, gives you the most, I want to say, expression over the ability to use his gun as much as possible. As stated before, you're able to do jab one into gun, or you can do your rapid jabs into gun as well. Gun isn't necessarily always a guaranteed combo off of an attack, right? In some cases, if I knock my opponent up and they're in enough hit stun, sure, I can do that. In other cases, if I do the same thing and Jason air dodges, I want to wait out the air dodge before I pop the bullet. And the longer you hold this move, you're actually able to stall in the air as well. So as you saw, I was holding the gun, waiting for that dodge to finish, but I didn't really fall. I was pretty much defying gravity at that point. Now I was able to just stay in place and just kind of wait to be able to shoot him. And you do have the ability to kind of maneuver around a little bit while you're holding the gun as well and charging it. As you can see, I'm fading back. I can fade forward if I want to. And you have the ability to aim it up and down diagonally or just straight towards the opponent. Now, as you can see, that little line dictates just how much range the move has as well. So again, keep in mind, the more bullets, the better. But even if you have one bullet, don't feel like you're not able to actually use this move at all. The next move we're going to talk about is Agent Smith's down special. Agent Smith has a down special that enables him to summon another agent. Doing so will allow the agent to grab your opponent and throw them to you. Now, I know what you're thinking. There's so much potential with that move. Of course. Now, let me break it down for you. So, if you lightly press down special, the agent will appear, but will only go a set distance forward. Now, if you want the agent to go a bit more forward, let's say that you hold the button, the agent will actually go all the way almost to your opponent. So within this range, we're still able to catch Jason. Now, if Jason was a bit further away, it would be much harder to actually land this move, and in fact, the move wouldn't land and the agent would simply just disappear. So the cool thing about this move is, not only is it good to combo off of and of course to actually score ringouts from, but you can also use it to force your opponent to have to use a defensive option to try to avoid it. So let's say I summon an agent. I can travel behind it to actually try and hit Jason if the opponent decides to jump in that regard, or if they decide to dodge on the ground or of course roll, you can also travel behind the agent to actually punish them when they do that. So this has a lot of versatility in terms of its use. Definitely get creative and make the most of this move because it is on cooldown and you will not be able to create another agent until the move is back online. Something to note with your down special is that even being able to just follow behind it is strong in itself because your opponent has to watch out for the clone and you as well. So in this case, right, if I summon a clone and I throw it at Jason, Jason might be tempted to jump over it to avoid it and then I just hit him. One last thing to note with this move is that if you simply tap down special, you see the distance in which the clone ran. It ended around here. Now let's watch what happens if I summon a clone again, but this time instead, I hold the down special button for as long as possible. Goes a bit further. So just keep that in mind in terms of how far you want it to travel to threaten your opponent. Up next is going to be Rounded Up Special. This move allows Agent Smith to teleport to the opponent. It has a lot of knockback, but it doesn't go too far. The reticle you're able to control as much as possible. So if I want to go straight up, I can go straight up. If I want to go straight to the side, I can do that. If I want to go diagonally, I can do that. Or if I don't want to leave my spot, I can do that as well. So you want to use up special, especially in situations where your opponent has burned maybe a jump or a dodge off stage, and you're able to just snipe them. You can also snipe them as they're holding the ledge as well if you decide to just aim this down a little bit to catch them. I like to personally use this move a lot when I have my opponent above me because that's when they're most tempted to use a defensive option such as air dodge. So you pop them up as high as you can, and if you're able to read which direction they're going to dodge in, you can actually catch them, punish them, and kill them for it. So just keep in mind that this move might feel a little bit tricky to use at first because of the timing on it, but if you get really comfortable with it, you will find that you're able to get some really nice ring outs with this move at early damage. And it feels pretty rewarding because it's not necessarily something that's super guaranteed for you to get. So it does take you being able to guess and read your opponent's habits in order to punish them with it. Now, don't just think you can spam this willy-nilly as much as possible, because if you decide to do that, there is some lag at the end of it. Right here, I am trying to jump as much as I can, and I am not able to do anything. So there is a commitment to using this move. You can also use this move to recover as well. Went to the ledge. I'm able to do it here to even threaten a very strong move at the ledge if my opponent wants to try to ledge trap me here. And something also to mention, just like your other specials, you were able to recover with them as well, similar to the up special. Agent Smith's aerial specials, for the most part, are pretty similar to his grounded variants. So, for the aerial side special, you're still doing your dive gun. For aerial neutral special, you're still getting that command grab ball. For aerial down special, however, things get a little bit different. His aerial down special is a series of three shots where he pretty much is flipping over the opponent while shooting them. As you can see, because I had three in the chamber, I get three, but if I have one, I only get one bullet. But this puts Agent Smith in a situation where he's actually able to follow up off of it. So I'm gonna do this again with two bullets. My opponent ground splatted, so he popped up and I was able to at least get a spike. So depending on the character, depending on their weight, and of course, depending on how many bullets you have, will determine what move you are able to follow up with in that situation. So a lot of characters, when they're above their opponent, it's not a good look, right? I could try to land with this, I could try to land with this. So in Agent Smith's case, being able to have not only a gun to aim downward at the ground to threaten the opponent that is trying to basically exist under him and pressure him is a super strong tool to have to get out of a bad disadvantageous position. You want to use that move as much as possible. And of course, you can use it off stage as well. And then with his aerial up special, as shown before, it's quite literally the same thing as you would do on the ground. So not too much variety there, but not needed. Agent Smith's combo game centers around usually the use of his jabs and pretty much cutting them into his normals, his other normals, right? So as you can see, up attack leading into down air is very, very strong, especially because the down air is able to pop up the opponent and it allows you to follow up. Let's say, as you saw right there, I did a side attack in the air, right? But you can take things a little bit further, right? My opponent is at kill percent. I pop him with one bullet of my aerial down special, and I'm able to also get a side attack again as well. If you're looking for super early kills, you're usually going to hit the opponent in a way where you're able to make a read with the up special, right? And so that's where player skill comes heavily into factor, because the better the player, the more often they will be able to pull off such reads. But with practice, you will also be able to do that as well. Of course, comboing from down air into neutral attack is something I showed before, but even comboing in from up attack into a neutral attack might prove to be worth your time, or just simply shooting bullets to threaten your opponent and follow up. Agent Smith is a character that I want to say has set play elements to him, but also has the ability to box you up close. He's not a super duper duper heavy combo character, but he does have them, and the ones that he does are relatively strong in terms of how much damage you're going to do and what position it puts the opponent in after. Because again, having the ability to have a move like this that pops them up is super strong, and it's super threatening, because even if they dodge this move, you still have enough aerial momentum to continue to chase the opponent. Also, being able to have a clone that throws the opponent towards you is not only good for setting up for combos, but just for setting up kills as well. Granted, you have to actually hit the clone, but remember, the clone is pressure. So even if you throw this out and you don't land it for some reason, react to how your opponent reacts to the clone and punish them accordingly. We're gonna get into Agent Smith's perks. He has three of them. He has hand cannon. Smith's gun attacks will only shoot once, but if he has extra ammo, the attack will have a sweet spot at the end. Freeze protocol. Your agent will hold enemies in place instead of throwing them. Enemies can struggle to escape. So with freeze protocol, the clone actually holds the opponent in place and they're able to mash out to get out as quickly as possible. The thing about this is that because it doesn't throw the opponent at you, you're actually able to get certain follow-ups a bit easier, such as if I wanted to use this move, because they're not being thrown, I don't have to necessarily time a jump and use the move at the same time. So for those who do not want the opponent to be thrown into the air, so they might have an easier time at actually following up, this can accomplish the same results, but a bit easier. But if you have an opponent that is relatively good at mashing out, then you might have trouble because they're going to be getting out of the clone really quick. And buddy system. Use your up special on an ally to attach to them, then use an extended version of the attack. Be sure to effectively choose which perk you like the most. For me personally, I'm a big fan of Freeze Protocol and Hand Cannon. So those will probably be the perks that I revolve my game around the most. Now then, let's actually see what Agent Smith looks like in a full-blown match. In this match, I will be trying to give a little bit commentary as I am playing, but this is just so you guys can actually see the character in action while playing against an opponent. So, hope you enjoy. So as Smith in this matchup versus Jason, I'm going to try to use my range to the best of my ability, while of course baiting Jason as much as possible and using pretty much his wind-up speed against him as well as his size. I'm going to try to make this as difficult as possible for him to get in while having a keen focus on his disadvantage state, because as you can see, taking even a little bit of damage from Jason is very dangerous, and I don't want to do that. So playing as safe as possible is the name of the game, and I feel like Smith is pretty good at doing that. It's gonna be a first life for me. Actually, it'll start off a good combo. I tried to punish that dodge to the side, but I wasn't able to get it. But right now, I'm just applying as much damage as I possibly can while trying to threaten the gun while he's off stage. Try to read a dodge with that. It wouldn't have KO'd, but it would have not only done good damage, but it would have actually popped him up again and put him in a bad scenario. Nice side of air from Jason. I'm gonna land, hit him with spike, dodges down. I cover that with my up attack. And as you can see, I am really using this up attack and this down attack in the air to get as much mileage as possible. And even on the ground, I am not allowing him to land on me. Able to catch him before the miss popped away. Got a little too greedy trying to go for that extra down air, and he was able to kill me for that, which is good. Nice attempt at approaching, but I'm able to stuff out that dash attack. Knock him away with my down attack. Avoid the dash attack again. Gonna put him in the air. I actually missed the follow-up, and I really wanted to put him in the air at that low percent because I just wanted that sweet, sweet damage I would have gotten from that scenario. Little early charge on that gun for me. And I tried to do the up special down like this because I thought he was going to dodge into me or try to land into me. I actually missed the dive. I get one jab though. I wanted to do a jab into gunshot and I get it there, but he's not at the ledge, so I'm not able to kill with that. I'm gonna pressure him there off of the missed side special, and that's going to be the game. I actually think we have time for another one too. Let's run another. So as you guys can see, it's all about trying to use your ranged moves as much as possible to try to force your opponent to come in, and then you just literally body them with your up close. So right there, I wait for the dodge. My dash attack gets punished. It's an actually good chain combo from the Jason player. Nice. And right now I'm not in a good position. Jason is actually applying a lot of pressure and a lot of damage quick, but I'm able to get off the ledge and actually sprinkle in some damage in the meantime. And that was a perfect neutral attack at the ledge. I tried to get up a little bit too fast. So let's see if I can actually make this comeback. I get a shot off the dash attack into a forward air, and I am using this forward air to try to get as much damage as possible. And even while sending my opponent upward with the aerial up attack, I'm able to confirm into that spike at the bottom of the blast zone to get that kill. Nice attempt. My jabs off, knock him off the stage. One shot. So right now I'm just trying to play right outside of Jason's range so I can punish him on that miss grounded side attack. Uses the miss to actually catch me. That's really good on his part. I'm gonna get hit with missed again. And so far this match is pretty competitive between the both of us. I am able to die really early though, so now I have to play a bit safer. Gonna punish that. He uses the miss, but he doesn't land right on top of me. I wanted to punish that with my up special. And right now I'm just trying to bait out a situation where I'm able to catch him with that. But to get back on pretty safe horizontally, I decide to use all three of my bullets, not only to get damage, but just to knock him away off of my side special. Gonna put a clone at the ledge in hopes of grabbing him, but I actually get hit with that side air and die. I'm gonna wait for the dodge. I don't get anything off of it, but my clone is gonna grab him. He misses. I get that one shot. It's not enough. If I had three in the chamber, he definitely would have died, but I'm gonna anti-air with that grounded up attack to get that life. Good dash attack from Jason. Pop him up. Spike combo down. Bullets, wait for that dash attack to end, throw the clone at him, grab him. I face the other way, so I'm not able to get the follow-up. Good gunshot to close the gap between us. Spending a lot of resources though right now. Throwing out the clone to make him jump, I don't get the punish. He does the mist, I don't die, and that's good armor. Very scary situation. I jump and I get hit and I got cleaned up for that. good play by the Jason player. And we can actually run one more to close out the entire set. So that was good adaptation from his part. And actually, that side special from Jason was putting in a lot of work. So I'm going to have to try to play around that even harder this time around. That was very risky business though, trying to do that dash attack like that. I was not too close to him, so I was able to position myself away from it. I'm going to go ahead and actually get the punish with my own dash attack. So right now, I got pretty good damage, able to pop him up. Tried to wait for a side dodge, but he does a neutral one instead. Punish that miss, throw the clone down. Don't get a grab. I wanted to try to put it at the ledge to grab him if he jumped above it, but he didn't do it. Let's shift things up. So right now, he's just trying to find his way back on. I hit two bullets, but not the third one that would have actually gotten us the kill. Throw him off. It's just a little too early on that. That would have been a huge kill. Knock him away. Charge my down attack at the ledge to kill him diagonally, and that's going to put me in the lead. Okay. But now I'm in a situation again. I have to use the shortcomings of Jason to my advantage. I know where he's weak, and I know that if he swings, I have enough time to punish him, and that's what I want to use to my advantage as much as possible. And so I actually want to try to make the Jason player come to me in this regard. So I'm going to be using my gun and using my clones as much as possible to make him feel like he has to approach. So even though I did lose there because I'm playing risky at the ledge, I still have a good enough lead, and I still have my range projectile. Clone is on cooldown. I'm gonna grab him and throw him off stage. Charge the gunshot. That's gonna be two shots to the blast zone. He's out of there. So I'm gonna grab off of that. As you can see, just stringing all of this damage together really fast, guys. All of this damage. Wait for the dodge, catch him with the up special. Not enough to kill yet though. And so right now, as you can see, he's having a hard time actually getting to the ground. And even though he landed horizontally there toward me, I'm able to gap close immediately with such a strong move such as grounded side special. I'm going to anti-air him with the up attack again. Charge my gunshot, not enough to do it. And so now I'm just waiting for him to get back on. That's not going to be enough to kill. Try to kill him with the side attack. I miss, but the side special is going to do it, and that's going to close out the set between my Agent Smith and this wonderful Jason player. Overall, I think Agent Smith is a very explosive character, and I like the fact that he has enough utility between his set play with his clone and his up special and his gun versus just his overall ability to box you up close as well with his normals. I think his combo game is solid, and I just like the way that this character flows a lot. I would recommend this character to all levels of play. And if you are amongst the more advanced or intermediate level, then you will also appreciate the set play and control that you get with his gun and his clone as well. Welcome, Agent Smith, to the MultiVersus roster, everyone. And thank you so much for watching this video. I greatly, greatly appreciate it. Be sure to subscribe to the MultiVersus YouTube channel down below. And if you want to find my own personal channel, you can find that in the description as well. Would love if you subscribe there too. Thank you guys so much for playing. I greatly appreciate your time. And please have a blast with Agent Smith. And let me know what character you want to see next. And if you have any questions, drop them down in the comment section of this video. This is NAKAT, your community manager over at Player First Games. Take it easy. Peace out. See you later.